DemocracyNow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. We begin today's show in Baltimore, where officials have lifted a 10 p.m. curfew and National Guard troops have begun to withdraw as peaceful protests continue over the death of Freddie Gray. Gray's family and attorney say his voice box was crushed. His spine was 80% severed at the neck, they say. This comes after Baltimore State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby dramatically announced Friday she'd filed charges against the six officers connected to Gray's arrest and transport on April 12, saying they illegally arrested Gray without probable cause, then ignored his pleas for medical help.
As the city's chief prosecutor, I've been sworn to uphold justice and to treat every individual within the jurisdiction of Baltimore City equally and fairly under the law. I take this oath seriously, and I want the public to know that my administration is committed to creating a fair and equitable justice system for all. No matter what your occupation, your age, your race, your color, or your creed, it is my job to examine and investigate the evidence of each case and apply those facts to the elements of a crime in order to make a determination as to whether individuals should be prosecuted. This is a tremendous responsibility, but one that I sought and accepted when the citizens of Baltimore City elected me as a state's attorney. And it's precisely what I did in the case of Freddie Gray. Once alerted about this incident, on April 13, investigators from my police integrity unit were deployed to investigate the circumstances surrounding Mr. Gray's apprehension. Over the course of our independent investigation in the untimely death of Mr. Gray, my team worked around the clock, 12 and 14 hour days, to canvass and interview dozens of witnesses, view numerous hours of video footage, repeatedly reviewed and listened to hours of police videotaped statements, surveyed the route, reviewed voluminous medical records, and we leveraged the information made available to us by the police department, the community, and the family of Mr. Gray. The findings of our comprehensive, thorough, and independent investigation, coupled with the medical examiner's determination that Mr. Gray's death was a homicide, which we received today, has led us to believe that we have probable cause to file criminal charges. While each of these officers are presumed innocent until proven guilty, we have brought the following charges. Officer Caesar Goodson is being charged with second-degree depraved heart murder, involuntary manslaughter, second-degree negligent assault, manslaughter by vehicle by means of gross negligence, manslaughter by vehicle by means of criminal negligence, misconduct in office for failure to secure a prisoner, failure to render aid. Officer William Porter is being charged with involuntary manslaughter, assault in the second degree, misconduct in office. Lieutenant Brian Rice is being charged with involuntary manslaughter, assault in the second degree, assault in the second degree, misconduct in office, false imprisonment. Officer Edward Nero is being charged with assault in the second degree, intentional, assault in the second degree, negligent, misconduct in office, false imprisonment. Officer Garrett Miller is being charged with intentional assault in the second degree, assault in the second degree, negligent, misconduct in office, and false imprisonment. Sergeant Alicia White is being charged with manslaughter, involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, misconduct in office. To the people of Baltimore and the demonstrators across America, I heard your call for no justice, no peace. Your peace is sincerely needed as I work to deliver justice on behalf of this young man. To those that are angry, hurt, or have their own experiences of injustice at the hands of police officers, I urge you to channel the energy peacefully as we prosecute this case. I have heard your calls for no justice, no peace. However, your peace is sincerely needed as I work to deliver justice on behalf of Freddie Gray. To the rank and file officers of the Baltimore City Police Department, please know that these accusations of these six officers are not an indictment on the entire force. I come from 5 generations of law enforcement. My father was an officer. My mother was an officer. Several of my aunts and uncles. My recently departed and beloved grandfather was one of the founding members of the first black police organization in Massachusetts. I can tell you that the actions of these officers will not and should not in any way damage the important working relationships between police and prosecutors as we continue to fight together to reduce crime in Baltimore. Thank you for your courage, commitment, and sacrifice for the betterment of our communities. Last but certainly not least, to the youth of this city, I will seek justice on your behalf. This is a moment. This is your moment. Let's ensure that we have peaceful and productive rallies that will develop structural and systemic changes for generations to come. You're at the forefront of this cause. And as young people, our time is now.
That was Baltimore State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby speaking on Friday. She's the youngest state's attorney of any major city in the United States. Police union officials are now calling for Mosby to appoint an independent prosecutor, saying her marriage to Baltimore City Council member Nick Mosby is a conflict of interest because his district includes the area where Gray was arrested. Marilyn Mosby addressed this during her news conference on Friday.
I don't see an appearance of conflict of interest. My husband is a public servant. He works on the legislative side. I am a prosecutor. I am also a public servant. I uphold the law. He makes the laws. And I will prosecute any case within my jurisdiction.
All 6 officers charged in Gray's death have since posted bonds of $250,000 to $350,000. Meanwhile, Alan Bullock, one of the 18-year-olds who turned himself in for participating in the riots, is facing a bond of $500,000. His stepfather, Maurice Hawkins, and mother, Bobby Smallwood, reacted to the amount in an interview with The Guardian.
That's my son on top of the police car with the cone in his hand, hitting the window. We don't condone that, and we believe in peace. I just want justice to be held and not to be, you know, him looked at as a career criminal or a thug.
My son, he's not a evil child. I mean, he's not somebody that go around and just hurt people. He really not. He was really upset about them police just walking free. You gave my son $500,000 bail for breaking a police window, and you gave these cops nothing for murder? That's crazy. That's crazy. That's not fair.
That's not justice.
That's not fair.
Other protesters in Baltimore have seen their bonds set as high as $100,000 for disorderly conduct.